So in the previous class, what we have discussed? We have discussed what is a program to generate the delay and what are the different instructions that we have used to call a subroutine program. So this was our subroutine program and this was our main program. Okay, this was our main program, right? Is it been understood? So that I'll go for another example. Any reply? Okay. So now there is one more example. We will see here it. Say the return address of a call instruction. Okay, so when we call and when the return instruction is going to be executed. So what will happen during a call instruction? Pushed during call and popped during return. What is pushed and what is popped during return? So during call, PC value is going to be pushed automatically by the assembler only. And during pop operation, the PC value will be, that is the return back address will be loaded into PC register. PC value will be sent upon stack. Okay. So during what? During call instruction, and from the stack, the PC value will be loaded back. That is when I execute, when the ALU executes the return instruction. Okay, so give me your time. So one more example is there in between that. This one. So here, this is one simple example to compare the jump and call instruction. Okay, so that here let us see that. Okay, so see that I have so many registers set here. I have a system clock of 12 megahertz. Okay, I have a serial buffer register, I have TH0, TL0, okay, which are timer. I have two timer registers, which are 16-bit register. Okay, TH0 is a 8-bit register. TH1 is a upper 8-bit register. This is lower 8-bit register. This is upper 8-bit register. TL0 is lower 8-bit register. TL1 is upper 8-bit register. So total 16-bit register. So I have different kinds of registers set here. TMOD is there. TCON, all these are special function registers. So R0 to R7, these are a general purpose register. Okay, B is there, which is also a special function register, accumulator, PSW, IP. IP is instruction pointer, or it is also called as PC, program counter. Okay, I think computer organization, I think you have gone through all these registers. Okay, interrupt execution, IE register, then PCON, DPH, DPL, stack pointer register. So whenever the reset happens, all the values are going to be 0000. All the register values are going to be 00. And PSW is also 00. But only stack pointer value will remain 07. And this is a code memory. This is a memory that I have. This is the memory. Okay. So starting from 00. So 00, this is 0 bit. 00012. Okay. 01 00 memory location. First memory 001 memory location. 002 memory location. Each memory location is of 8 bit size. Okay. Then 003 memory location up to 0F. After 0F, what I have? 10 10 11 12 13 up to 1F. Then again 20 up to 2F. Then 30 up to 3F, and so on. 70 up to 7F memory location. Okay, this is the memory location I have. Now here, what is happening? What we are looking into? Say we are comparing the call instruction and jump instruction, whether they are going to be executed or not. Say what I am doing, origin 00. Here one program I have written with having only two instructions. There is another program at ORG 10. See, 00 location, I have two instructions. 10 location, I have two instructions. So A call or L call, whatever it may be, call instruction is there and jump instruction is there. Here also A call and AJMP instruction is there. Then 20th memory location, L call is there, LJMP is there. 30th memory location, one more program is there, which is having only one instruction, only SJMP is there. 40th memory location, one more program, which is having MOV A,77H. 50th memory location, I have only one instruction, here also one instruction. So that instruction is having, okay, this 50th memory location, I have two instructions. One is MOV A,88H and return. Two instructions I have. So what will happen when I start at 00 memory location? I am writing two instructions. So A call is a 2-byte instruction. We know that A call is a 2-byte instruction. L call is a 3-byte instruction. Okay. So what will happen? A call will consume 2 bytes. So 0000 and 0001. So 2 bytes are used for storing A call. SUB is the address. SUB is the address. Where is SUB written? See here, 50th memory location. At the 50th memory location, SUB is written. Okay. What is inside this 50th memory location? MOV A,88H. Now, when I have told you about a pipeline, I think decoding. First, okay, you have gone through pipeline operation, no? Have you gone through pipeline operation in computer organization? Reply me first. No. Okay, no problem. I will tell you. The thing is, whenever we write any instruction, and when we start executing the instruction, there are three stages each instruction has to go through. Okay, there are three stages each instruction has to go through. First stage is fetching the data. First stage is fetching the data. Fetching the data means calculating the address and collecting the data from the memory location is called as fetching operation, fetching stage. Fetch is collecting the data. Then after collecting the data from the memory, that data is going to be decoded. decode means what? The data is going to be converted into hexadecimal number, decoded. The instruction fetching. Instruction is being fetched here. Instruction is being decoded, and then after decoding, that instruction is going to be executed. That is, ALU is actually executing the operation in the third stage execution. Okay, so suddenly the instruction will not be executed. First, the instruction is taken. That stage is called as a fetching stage. After fetching, the instruction, whatever instruction is being written, that is converted into, that is decoded first, because what have to be done, that has to be known, no? So for that, decoded, and then after decoding, according to the data, whatever the decoded data is there, the operation will be executed. Operation will be performed. Okay. So what will happen here? So here, this is one program which is having A call SUB, and second instruction is AJMP. So what will happen here? First, whenever I'm writing any instruction, this instruction is going to be stored into 00 and 01 memory location. So what is a hexadecimal decoded value for this ACALL SUB? ACALL is the value for ACALL. ACALL is a 2 bytes. ACALL is 2 byte instruction. Okay. So ACALL SUB. SUB is the address. Now ACALL is 11. The value of ACALL is 11. Then what is the SUB? Is an address. Where is that address? 50. So what is remaining here? 50. Okay. The address is only 8 bit. ACALL is a 2 byte. Okay. It jumps only within 2 kilobytes. It jumps only within 2 kilobytes. So now, as a subject, SUB is a label, and that SUB is denoting to 50H. So 50H is going to be stored into 0000 and 0001. So total 2 bytes are taken here to store this one instruction. ACALL means ACALL letter will not be stored. It is being converted into hexadecimal. Okay, it is being decoded into a binary number. So the binary number of this ACALL is 11. 11, and SUB is their address. What is address? 50. 50 is going to be stored into the memory. Then AJMP here. AJMP is 1 byte, and the value of AJMP is 01. The value of AJMP is 01. And what is here? Here is a label. Where it is present? Here. So what is the address? 40. So here it is 40. Then I am starting at 10H. Now call instruction is there. SUB is there. So at 10. So call means, okay, it is A call only. It is A call. It is not only a call, it is a A call. So A call, SUB. Again, what is A call? It is 11. See, 11 is written here in the 10H memory locations, because origin, I am starting at 10H memory location. So 11, and what is SUB? Again, it is 50 address. So that is also stored into the memory. Now again, JMP here in the 10H, this has taken 2 bytes. So what is next address? It is 12. 10, 11 is being occupied by ACALL. 12 and 13 will be occupied by jump. So what is a decoded address of a decoded value of this jump here? Here is 40. Jump is 80. Something different is being written up here. Okay. Because here is being written here, at the 40 address, and the jump instruction works only within a single program. Jump instruction, we know that jump instruction works only within a single program. Okay, so the call instructions are working for separate program. Jump instruction is working only within a single program. So some other value is being stored here. 2C something, 2C value is being stored here, which is not where anywhere, it is not been here. So here means 40, but 40 will not be stored here because this here is in the 40 and 40 is not inside 10th memory location. It is a separate program. This is a separate program. So that is why jump here, the here value, what it is taking, it is taking 2C. Maybe it is invalid address. It is taking invalid address 2C. Now one more program is there, 20H, where I have written both are, one is LCALL and another one is LJMP. So here what will happen? I think this has to be 40. This has to be 40, but it will not jump there. Okay. So LCALL SUB. So again, what is LCALL? LCALL SUB is going to be 3-byte instruction. ACALL was 2-byte. LCALL is 3-byte instruction, starting at memory location 20. So what will be the next instruction? 20, 21, 22 will be occupied by LCALL. So 23 will be the next address. Okay. So what will happen? 20 memory location, 12, 00, 50. SUB is 50 and LCALL is going to be 12, 00. Again, LJMP is another instruction. What is LJMP? It is also a 3-byte instruction. 23, 24, 25. So 23, 24, 25. 40 is here. Here is where? Where it is here? That 40H. Then then it is 02 and 00. Then where we are going for SJMP, short jump. Short jump is also within 256 bytes. Okay, so 256 bytes, but again some value, other value is there. ATH, so as it is, SJMP or JMP, both are same. Short jump or jump. Okay, both are same. So again, it is going to be taking some other value, 0E, because it should be only within a single program, in a only one program, within the program. Then at 40H, move A,77. So this is a 2-byte instruction. This is a 2-byte instruction. So move is, opcode is converted into binary, so 74, and move A is 74, 77 is a data, direct data, 77. And at 50H, move A is what? 74, and what is the data? 88, so 88. Then what is there? Return is at 52. RET is a single byte instruction, so 22. The value of RET is 22. Okay, that is going to be stored into 52H. Now, what will happen? First, ALU will take this data, ACALL SUB. So, what will happen? ALU will directly, ACALL, we are calling this subject, this function, no? SUB. So ALU will first come here and it will fetch this instruction and it will decode this instruction while it is executing. While it is executing this ACALL instruction, SUB, the new address 50.0.0.50 address will be stored upon PC. Before that, what will happen? This PC value was 0002. Okay, PC value is 0002. This value is going to be pushed upon the stack. Pushed upon the stack. So this is 08th address. This is 09 address. Push happens. Then take the new address. SUB is there now. Take the new address. What is new address? 0050. So PC will be equal to 0050. Now what will happen? This data, the ALU will come to PC. ALU will directly come here. So what it will execute? What it will take the data? It will take move A. So that is what? 74, 88 and 22. First it will take 74, 88. Move A comma 88H. So now this data is going to be copied into A and then return instruction. So 22 will be executed. So if return instruction is been executed, it will pop the data from the, so actually when ALU is here, the new value of PC is going to be 52. When ALU executes this return instruction, while executing, PC value will be 53 because return is a 1-byte instruction. So the next value will be of the PC will be 53. Okay. Now what will happen? When this is being executed, a new value will be loaded into PC. What is the new value? That is pop operation is happening. Pop operation is happening. So what will happen here? 0002. The new value of PC will be 0002. So where the processor will go after executing this return? It will go to PC. Where is PC? PC is here. So again, it will come here. Again, it will come here. Now again, AJMP. It is a jump, a long jump. That is 2 kilobytes of the memory. So AJMP is happening to here. So what will happen? But as this will not be executed. This will not be executed. Because why? Because here is a label from the external program. Here is not a label from the within the program. It is not from within the program. It is from external program. AJMP is not used for jumping from main program to subroutine program. Only call instructions are used to jump from main program to subroutine program. So this will not be executed. That is why it is marked with the red line. So here, this will not be executed. Only this has been executed. After this, ALU will come here. It will execute this. And then it will execute this. And after this, it is going back to AJMP. But this instruction will not be executed. Then ALU will come to ORG10H. So here ALU will come. What is the new value of PC? It is 0010. So when this is been executing, what will be the new value of PC? It will be 0012. So now what will happen? It is also A call. It is also A call SUB. Again, from here where the CPU is jumping, to this program, this instruction. So after execution of this instruction, return instruction is going to be executed. So where it will return back? It will return back to 0012. Because this was the data which has been pushed up on the stack, 0012. And when return is being executed, 0012 will be taken back into PC. So ALU will come to 0012. But again, jump here. Here is there, but it is not in the within the same program. So that is why this will also not be executed. Okay, you are understanding why the jump instruction is not executing and why the call instruction is been executing. So in the new address, new program, L call is there. SUB, again, we are going from this to subroutine program. This instruction is executed and return instruction is executed, and we are coming back to 0023. LJMP here. Again, this will not be executed. So ALU will go to here. SJMP here. Again, here is outside of this program. So this instruction will also not be executed. Okay. So here it will come 40H. This will be executed. And here it will come. This will be executed. Is it understood? Okay. So now we'll go with the next one. The return address. So one more example is there. Say at the instruction ORG 1233. So this is the starting address. Okay. The first instruction and the starting address label, the label of this 1233 is what? Main. Okay. Then the first instruction of this 1233 is DIV. AB divide A and B. So first this will be executed. Okay. During execution of this instruction, what will be the new value of PC? It will be 1234. 1234. So as this is only 1 byte instruction, PC will be incremented by 1. So what will be the new value of PC? It will be 1234. What will be the new value of SP? It will remain 071 because we are not jumping anywhere and we are not storing anywhere. So stack content is empty. That is 08H is empty. 08, 09, 0A, 0B, 0C. We'll take some values here. Where the SP is pointing? SP is pointing to 07. Okay. Now, stack content. This is my stack memory. It is starting at 08th memory location. No. So this is empty. Stack operation. There is no stack operation. Now, what is the second instruction? 1234. No. The ALU has to go to 1234. So ALU will come here. 1234. So during execution of this instruction, LCALL SUBR, what will be the new value of PC? It will be, as LCALL is a 3 byte. So 34, 35, 36 will be consumed. What will be the new value of PC? It will be 1237. 1237. Okay. Now this will be executed second. LCALL SUBR 3. What is LCALL? First, what it will do? First, it will push the data of the PC. What is the data of PC? 1237. Where it will push? Upon the stack pointer. What is stack pointer locating at? 07. Now, what will happen when the push occurs? The SP will be incremented by 1. SP will be 08. The lower byte will be stored 37. 37H, and upper byte also will be stored. Again, it will be incremented by 1. 09. What is the new value? 12H. 1237 will be stored upon. 1237 will be stored upon the stack memory. Okay. 09. 08 and 09. This is 09. This is 08. Okay, and what is SUBR? SUBR, where is SUBR? Here is SUBR. What is the address of SUBR? 5678. So what will be loaded with the PC? PC will be having the new address 5678 because we are calling SUBR. So that is, what is the address of SUBR? It is 5678. 5678. Okay. Right. So push is happening here. Now, whether this will be executed? No. We are directly jumping from this position to where? Towards this address, SUBR. Okay. So here, what is happening? ORG 5677. This is another program, separate program. So what is the first instruction of 5677? Clear A. What is second instruction of 5677? Yes, set bit C. It means carry flag is going to be 1. So whether this will be executed? No, because we are directly jumping to 5678. So this instruction will be executed third. So first instruction is being executed, second instruction is being executed, third instruction will not be executed, but this instruction will be executed third. Okay, so what is the new value of PC while executing the third instruction, this instruction? So the next instruction, 5679. So PC will be having 5679. It was having 5678. So this instruction is being started executing. So it will be having next address of the instruction. So stack pointer value, what is the new value of stack pointer? It is remaining at 09, no? So 09 only. What is the value of stack pointer? 1237 is being stored here, 1237. Then again, what will happen? This instruction will be executed after this set bit clear, set bit carry flag. Then clear carry flag will be executed. So while executing this, what will be the address of the PC? 567A. So 567A. Okay. Then what is executing? 567A. Return instruction is executed. So once the return instruction is being executed, whether the CPLV is going to be executed? No. After fifth instruction, sixth instruction has to be executed now. So what will be the sixth instruction? Return. What is happening here? Pop operation is happening here. So what will happen? What will be the new value of PC? When it is executing 567A, PC value will be 567B. 567B. So this address will be having. But return instruction is there. Now what it will do? It will pop the data of the PC back where the data has been stored into a stack. So what is the data has been stored into a stack? 09, 1237. So minus one. Pop means minus one, no? Decrements. So first it will decrement by one. First it will take the data and decrement by one. And again it will be take the data 37 and decrement by one. What is the new value of SP? It is going to be 07. And it is going to be empty. And this value is going to be loaded into PC because of RET. Okay. So new value of PC is going to be 1237. Where the processor has to jump? It has to jump to 1237. So from this will not be executed. Directly we are jumping back to 1237. So this will be multiply AB is there. So this will be sixth instruction. So this is 1 byte instruction. So that is why when 1237 is going to be executed, the new value of PC will be 1238. Is it being understood? Okay. So here one more example is there. I think you go through, see, I want some work from you also. Go through this indirect addressing mode, using a direct address mode or indirect addressing mode. Go through this program and one more program is there. This program, saving the program status before executing the subroutine. Okay. So you go through these two programs. They are very easy. Understand them first. Then in the next class, if you have any doubts, we will clear it within these two examples. Okay. Or else I will go for another program. These two programs, I am leaving up to you to know the operation, how exactly which instruction is going to be executing and what is actually happening. Okay, so go through these two programs, last two programs. And if you at all, if you don't understand the things, I will explain it in the next class. Okay, so in the next class, I will directly go to the another example. Okay, the last topic of the module. Fine. Okay, let me take an attendance.